It's time for another weekly installment of Bulls, Bears and Brokers with DJ Carmichael's David Bosio. David, always wonderful to see you. It has been a tough time on the equity markets, as we've been discussing over the last few weeks, and now with Christmas looming, it seems to be getting even quieter. So that all said, what have you seen in the capital raisings space in these tough times?
Yeah, although it's been hard out there, Danielle, we've still managed to see a few companies raising a little bit of money. And it's certainly harder out there in terms of the broad environment, but deals are still getting away. So one that I wanted to talk about today was Triangle Energy. I believe Triangle have been on the show before, so some of the viewers may be familiar with Triangle, but we've been lucky enough to work with Triangle off and on over the last, call it 12 months, and they've been what we like to consider quite a lucky company. They have a very interesting oil-producing asset called it's the Cliffhead oil field, which is just off Western Australia, the West Australian coast. It's in shallow water, but it's just off Dongara, for those who know the West Australian coastline. And they have an existing oil field which produces at the current time. So about a year ago, they actually drilled a very exciting prospect called Xanadu. And Xanadu was a commercial discovery, and that was a very good catalyst for the share price, and they had a nice run on the back of that. So over the last 12 months, I've been working away on their existing assets as well as trying to do more with their exploration portfolio. But one of the things that they managed to do was spin out through a new IPO a subsidiary, which was a non-core asset based in Queensland called State Gas, and that's now listed under the ticker GAS, Gas. So Triangle own about north of 30% of that new listed company. They've been listed for a little while now, but they've had some extremely positive exploration success themselves only over the last week, and that share price has really rallied quite strongly. So for both Gas and Triangle, we've seen a little bit of an uptick in their share prices over the last week, but most importantly, it's on the back of some exploration success, which could be for Gas, the Queensland story, an onshore discovery, which could be quite meaningful in the future. So only about a week ago, Triangle raised a few million dollars via a rights issue, which was fully underwritten, and a placement. And those investors, of which we were fortunate enough to participate, they've actually had a good little kick up in the share price. So that's been one to watch. Most importantly, though, they've got a good exploration portfolio and a good production portfolio. So definitely one to keep an eye on. And if that success continues, we could see some good things from them over the next 12 months as well.
David, another thing we've been discussing quite frequently is rumoured transactions in the market. Have there been any more to add to the discussion?
Yeah, so again, we may be trying to fill the gaps in a little bit here, but one that's really interesting, especially again based in Western Australia, is Buckridge Group. So for those who know, Len Buckridge was quite a reclusive billionaire who passed away recently. There are a whole bunch of succession issues. And what they have is essentially a very large family sitting on a massive private empire, which is essentially a consolidation of building materials businesses, mines themselves, and a whole lot of vertically integrated companies servicing essentially that building and mining services sector. They recently appointed Macquarie Capital as advisor to essentially sell the business. So I guess the family essentially taken control now of the company following Len Buckridge's passing. I have no interest in running these businesses any longer and have just put them up for sale essentially. So what I think we're going to see there is a whole heap of opportunities coming out of that sector. And one that I think is worth just taking a bit of a look at is Brickworks. Now Brickworks a few weeks ago made a sale of around $115 million worth of Soul Pattinson shares. So Soul Pattinson is a large shareholder of the company, but they also have cross shareholding. So they've sold down a portion of their shares in Soul Pats, and that's freed up around $115 million in cash. Now, the commentary around that from the Brickworks board is that that sale down of shares is really to strengthen the balance sheet and reduce some of their debt. But for those who are, I guess, closer to the sector, they may say, well, perhaps they're strengthening their balance sheet more to take advantage of, say, one of these opportunities coming out of the BGC suite of assets. They have a big brick business as well, so this could be a terrific opportunity for a company like Brickworks. Now, that again is a bit of a rumour, and it's a theory, but it is certainly one of those things where we're going to see some of the major players in that building services sector and potentially mining services sector starting to try and take opportunities of some of these assets that are going to be shaken as a result of this sell.
And David, we have recently seen the collapse of RCR Tomlinson, a major player in the construction scene here in Australia. Do you think the timing of that being close to the changes we're anticipating in Buckridge Group, do you think they'll play off each other in any way?
Absolutely. I just feel that all these, like all these things, there are real assets in these companies. They're very large companies, and often it's a combination of difficult trading conditions, over extension of debt facilities, etc., that bring them down. But within all of these businesses, there are certainly some real jewels, and I think we're going to see some of the cashed up players out there taking advantage of that trend.
Now let's turn to talk of mergers and acquisitions. GrainCorp are now in play for takeover. How do you see this playing out?
Yeah, this is a really interesting one. It's a big transaction. It's worth north of $2 billion Aussie, and long-term asset partners have come out this week following a strategic review, I guess, by the GrainCorp management team. Long-term asset partners have launched a non-binding proposal, which values a takeover of around, or a change of control transaction of at around $10.42 cash per share. Now, the stock itself is only trading in the low $9 region, so the market hasn't fully embraced this as a done deal. But what it does is really put the whole company in the spotlight, and I think it's going to shake out any other potential bidders. So I think this can go two ways. The management of the company have come out and said, well, we'll obviously, we're doing our work to really assess whether this proposal is worth taking to the next level. We could see an emerging bid come out from another group. There are a lot of companies out there, global agricultural groups, who would certainly look at this as a compelling transaction. So there certainly could be some competitive tension out there or competitive bidding. And alternatively, we may see the board of GrainCorp come out, endorse the deal in the absence of a superior offer, which would mean that there's certainly a potential increase in the share price if that were to happen, given the indicative bid price is significantly higher than where the stock's currently trading. So definitely one to watch. It's a big transaction. A couple of billion dollars is obviously big for the Australian market. So this could be a very interesting one that's going to play itself out over the next few months.
David, do you expect that we'll see increased activity in the next week or two as people try to finish off those last bits of business before heading off for Christmas and a new year?
Absolutely. I think it's the same in every sector, whether you've been in retail or the investment markets. There's a lot of deals being thrown around at the moment. We are seeing a lot of deal flow. Companies are looking to try and capitalise on any windows to raise a little bit of money. But also, I do feel that we are in a slightly more difficult situation given the global markets. From where we see the world, there is a little bit of investor apathy at the moment. There is no real rush to put money into the market when you can kind of say, well, let's just come back in January. Nothing's really going to change between now and then, especially given the US-China scenario that's currently playing itself out. So I do feel that we are going to finish the year with a little bit of a flurry. However, I do feel that compared to last year, which was quite euphoric at this time, I feel that this is certainly more subdued in terms of what companies are up to.
Well, we look forward to seeing what comes up in the next week for us to discuss. David Bosio, thank you.
Thank you, Daniel.